was a man who knew the road, and the writing was written on the stone. In the ancient time, an artist led the way, but no one seemed to understand. In his heart he knew the artist must be true, but the legend of the rent was way past due. Well, you think you'll be just fine without me, but you're mine. You think you can kick me out of the band? Well, it's just one problem there. The band is mine. How can you kick me out of what is mine? You're not hardcore unless you live hardcore. But the legend of the rent was way.
On today's episode of Problem Solvers, we're going to analyze Thomas Robert Malthus's influence on economics and solve some related rent problems. Let's get started. As you may have learned in class, Malthus studied all things concerning population. His main contribution was his emphasis on the relationship between food supply and population. Malthus theorized that people do not overpopulate to the point of starvation because they change their behavior in the face of economic incentives. The Malthusian growth model looks like this, where P0 equals the initial population, R equals the rate of growth, and T equals time. R, in this case, is also known as the Malthusian parameter. Now let's solve a problem. In 2012, Princeland has a population of 30,000. The town has been growing at a rate of 5% per year. What will the population be in 2017? We must plug these variables into the equation to solve this problem. Here, t equals 5 because the difference between 2017 and 2012 is 5 years. The answer, once you plug this into your calculator, is 157,691. And that's it for this edition of Problem Solvers. Thanks for joining me.
I've got students to voice in, and I've got news for rejoicing. Now a new sun is rising, I count my blessings. That I'm safe when I'm resting, furniture in my nesting. Not by force, I'm suggesting, you count your blessings. I've got love and assurance, I've got new health insurance. I've got strength and endurance, so I count my blessings. And give thanks to the master, that through all the disaster, we're still here together after. Better count your blessings.
Count your blessings. Cause yo, this year, can't wait till it gets here. 7/21/09, my first sun will shine. And it's amazing, I'm about to be raising another made man. And like his dad, they'll praise him. And some will hate him, just cause we building a nation. Like Bob did with Damien, the world will embrace him. Girls will chase him, foresee they will not break him. And when I'm not around, you look for God and thank
I've
him.
Got somewhere to
Good afternoon and welcome to Economics Central. Today we'll be discussing John Stuart Mill's theory of utilitarianism. With me, I have Angeline Legiro, who knows a great deal of information regarding this theory. Welcome, Angeline.
Thank you. I'm so happy to be here.
Great. Let's get started. First off, can you explain the concept of utilitarianism for us?
Of course. Utilitarianism is an ethical theory holding that the proper course of action is the one that maximizes the overall happiness.
And how does John Stuart Mill implement this theory into his work?
Mill's famous formulation of utilitarianism is known as the greatest happiness principle. Mill's major contribution to utilitarianism is his argument for the qualitative separation of pleasures. Mill argues that intellectual and moral pleasures are superior to more physical forms of pleasure.
I understand. How does Mill define the difference between higher and lower forms of happiness?
Mill defines this difference with the principle that those who have experienced both tend to prefer one or the other.
I realize that Mill argues that utilitarianism coincides with natural sentiments that originate from human social nature. Can you explain this argument?
Yes. If society were to embrace utilitarianism as an ethic, people would naturally internalize these standards as morally binding.
Seems like we've learned a lot today regarding John Stuart Mill's theory of utilitarianism. Thank you, Angeline.
You're welcome. It was my pleasure.
Thank you all for watching Economist Central. Be sure to check out John Stuart Mill's book, Utilitarianism.
And we're all welcome through his door, so I got my blessings. And give thanks to the master, that through all the disaster, we're still here together after, so I got my blessings.
I think you're looking too hard for it, with the double law under your garage door. Appreciate the things you work hard for, and count your blessings.